I play a woman named Kim, who is working as a cable news producer and gets the opportunity to go become an on-camera reporter in Afghanistan at a time when her network is very shorthanded abroad. And she goes thinking she's going to be there for 3 months and ends up staying there for 3 years, three insane, hard partying years.
I play Tanya, who's also a war correspondent already in Afghanistan when Kim comes over, and she kind of takes Kim under her wing, and then they become friends, and she's pretty impressed with Kim, and they have a bit of healthy rivalry, and by the end, it's starting to look a little unhealthy,
It becomes less healthy as it
yeah,
goes on.
yeah, and then she's kind of like, I don't want to be like you.
I have so much admiration for Kim because we pretended to do things that Kim really did, go into a dangerous area and interview a warlord, put on a full burqa to make her way safely into the streets of Kandahar and to get stories that she wouldn't have had access to. So it was pretty cool to just even get to meet her and to have her book as a source for this movie. She's pretty badass. I think I would be a real good domestic reporter covering like
I think I'd be good. I think I have the partying side of it down. I could do that really well. I can't even imagine what it would be like. It's easy to sit on this side of things and be like, sure, I'd give it a shot. But who knows how it would actually be in reality. It's, yeah, not something I don't think we can fathom.
I have a lot of favorite scenes in the movie. One of my favorite scenes in the movie is the scene I have with Chris Abbott, where Chris Abbott is really doing all the work in the scene where he quits. He works with me as a translator and a fixer, and he feels that my character is starting to get reckless and put him in situations that are too dangerous. And he gives this beautiful speech about the nature of war reporting and people getting addicted to adrenaline, and he's just so good in that scene.
It's funny you say that because my favorite scene is with Chris Abbott in it as well, and it's when he takes you to the airport at the end, and it's just a really beautifully genuine moment where it's so rare that you just see an actual genuine male and female friendship on screen where there are no ulterior motives. It comes across as really, really honest and beautiful to me. I got all teary-eyed at that moment. And my favorite scene to shoot would have been when we were in the karaoke bar and Martin had to. Oh, actually, no. When we were all doing the karaoke, do you remember, like, in the other room, and we were all like meant to be like, sloppy drunk, like wasted, but it's 10 a.m. and we're sober, and we're like, trying to do karaoke badly, which. It sounded bad anyway, but it was just so ridiculous to be like pretending to be that drunk when
Three
we
in the
weren't
morning, ten
drunk.
in the morning.
Yeah.
I hope they will laugh. I do think the movie's funny. I hope they will be moved by the beauty of that location, even though we faked it, and the kind of humanness of the story, that in spite of its extreme location, that it's a relatable story, hopefully, of someone wanting to take a risk in their life and change their life, and also that every character in the story is kind of. I mean, I keep thinking of Billy Bob's character, of just like in terms of the politics of the movie, that just the Billy Bob plays a colonel who by the end of the movie is a general, and is just. The best intentions of trying to be helpful in Afghanistan, and that it's just an untamable, kind of unknowable place that changes all these people's lives.
In the movie National Treasure, the good guys in the movie use Google and the bad guys use Yahoo. For this and more movie facts, click on more videos.